Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We're taking a look at pivot tables this week in Excel 2007. Again, to create a pivot table, it's very easy. Go to Insert, Pivot Table, click OK, and then just choose the fields you want. So, yesterday we built something, I think it was Region, Product, and Revenue. And I want to take a look at, now we've printed this out for our manager, and the manager asked for something different. The first thing they're going to ask for, possibly, is, hey, I want to rearrange the column labels and the row labels. Well, that's easy to do. We just grab the field down here in the pivot table field list and drag the heading to a new spot. So, if you need to rearrange two columns, you're in great shape. Now, let's say that the manager wants to see the customer data as well. Well, we have a couple of options for this. If I just choose the customer field, it's automatically going to go to the row labels, and what we're going to see is the first product and the customers who bought that product. But we might want to see the first customer and the products they bought, and that's easy enough to do. In the pivot table field list, we're just going to take the customer heading and move it before the word product. Now you'll see we have the first customer and the products they bought, next customer and the products they bought, and so on. While we have this view of the data, there's one thing that's very annoying to me about pivot tables. This cell. I believe that that cell should have a zero and not be blank. They make it blank to say that, hey, there were no records where ABC in the central region was sold to that customer. But I would prefer to have zeros, and we can control that. Basically, just want to right-click inside the pivot table and choose Pivot Table Options. On the Label and Format tab, there's a setting that says, for empty cells, show zero. Click OK. And you'll see that that fills in all of the cells within the data area with zeros when there were no sales in that particular area. So, as you need to rearrange a pivot table, you can simply drag headings from place to place to place within the pivot table. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.